श्री कुमार मंगलम बिरला जी, चेयरमैन ऑफ आदित्य बिरला ग्रुप, रिस्पेक्टेड डिग्निटरीज ऑफ द किंगडम ऑफ थाईलैंड, मेंबर्स ऑफ बिरला फैमिली एंड मैनेजमेंट, बिजनेस लीडर्स फ्रॉम थाईलैंड एंड इंडिया, फ्रेंड्स नमस्कार, सवादी ख्वाब। We have gathered here to celebrate the Savarna Jayanti, our golden jubilee of the global presence of the Aditya Birla Group in Suvarnabhumi, Thailand. This is truly a special occasion. I congratulate the team of the Aditya Birla Group. We just heard Kumar Mangalam Birla ji talk about the commendable work the group is doing in Thailand and beyond. It is creating opportunities and prosperity for many. Friends, we are here in Thailand with whom India has strong cultural linkage, and we are marking 50 years of a leading Indian industrial business in this nation. This reaffirms my belief that commerce and culture have inherent powers to unite. For centuries, monks and merchants ventured out to places far and wide. They have traveled far from home and mixed with many cultures. May the bonds of culture and commerce keep bringing the world closer in the times to come. Friends, I am eager to give you a picture of some positive changes happening in India today. I say this with full confidence. This is the best time to be in India. In today's India, many things are rising and many are falling. Ease of doing business is rising, and so is ease of living. FDI is rising, our forest cover is rising, the number of patents and trademarks are rising, productivity and efficiency are rising, pace of infrastructure creation is rising, number of people getting top quality healthcare is rising. At the same time, number of taxes are falling, tax rates are falling, red tapism is falling, cronyism is falling, corruption is falling, the corrupt are running over for cover, middlemen in the corridors of power are history. Friends, India has seen many success stories in the last 5 years in various sectors. The reason for this is not the only governments. India has stopped working in a routine bureaucratic manner. Transformative changes are arising due to ambitious missions undertaken. When these ambitions, missions are energized by the partnership of people, they become vibrant mass movements. And these mass movements achieve miracles. Things that were supposed to be previously impossible have now become possible. Coverage for basic necessities of life have reached almost 100%. Good examples for this are Jan Dhan Yojana, that has ensured near total financial inclusion, and Swachh Bharat Mission, where sanitation coverage has reached nearly all households. Friends, in India, we face a big problem. When it came to service delivery, that is the problem of leakages. The poor suffer most due to this. You will be shocked to know that for years, money was spent on the poor, which did not really reach the poor. Our government ended this culture thanks to DBT. DBT stands for Direct Benefit Transfer. DBT has ended the culture of middleman and inefficiency. It has left little scope for error. DBT has saved over $20 billion so far. You would have seen LED lights in homes. You know that they are more efficient and energy conserving. But do you know its impact in India? We have distributed more than 360 million LED bulbs in last few years. We have changed 10 million street lights to LED lights. Through this, we have saved about $3.5 billion. Carbon emissions have reduced as well. I firmly believe money saved is money earned. Energy saved is energy generated. This money is now being used to empower millions through our equally effective programs. Friends, in today's India, the contribution of the hard-working taxpayer is cherished. One area where we have done significant work is taxation. I am happy that India is one of the most people-friendly tax regimes. We are committed to further improving it even more. In the last 5 years, we have lowered the tax burden on the middle class considerably. We are now starting faceless tax assessment so that there is no scope for discretion or harassment. You would already have heard of India's decision to cut the corporate tax rates. Our GST has fulfilled the dream of economic integration of India. We want to work towards making it even more people friendly. All of what I have said just now makes India one of the world's most attractive economies for investment. Friends, India received $286 billion FDI in the last 5 years. This is almost half of the total FDI in India in the last 20 years. 90% of this came through automatic approvals, and 40% of this is greenfield investment. This shows that investors are taking long-term call on India. India's growth trajectory is reflected in several ratings. We are among the top 10 FDI destinations as per UNCTAD, moved up 24 places on the Global Innovation Index of WIPO in 5 years, but there are two of them I want to talk about specially. India has jumped 79 places in the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business ranking in 5 years. From 142 in 2014, we are 63 in 2019. This is a massive achievement. For the third year in a row, we are among the top 10 reformers. The variables for doing business in India are many. We are a large and diverse nation. There are the central, state, and local governments. In such a context, a directional shift shows our commitment to reforms. The people and government came together to make the business environment better. Friends, the other is India's improved ranking in the World Economic Forum's Travel and Tourism Competitiveness Index. From 65 in 2013, we are ranked 34 in 2019. This jump is among the biggest. The number of foreign tourist arrivals have also gone up by 50%. All of you know very well that a tourist will not go to a place until he or she finds comfort, convenience, and safety. Thus, if we are getting more tourists, it means that our efforts on the ground are bearing fruits. The fact that India has better roads, better air connectivity, better cleanliness, and better law and order is bringing the world to India. Friends, these rankings come after looking at the impact of transformation. These rankings are not a forecast. They are a manifestation of what has already happened on the ground. Friends, India is now pursuing another dream to become a $5 trillion economy. When my government took over in 2014, India's GDP was about $2 trillion. In 65 years, $2 trillion. But in just 5 years, we increased it to nearly $3 trillion. This convinces me that the dream of a $5 trillion economy will soon become a reality. We are going to invest $1.5 trillion for next generation infrastructure. Friends, if there is one thing I am specially proud of, it is India's talented and skilled human capital. No wonder India is among the world's largest startup ecosystems. India is one of the largest and fastest growing markets for digital consumers. There are 1 billion smartphone users and more than 500 million internet subscribers. We are keeping pace with Industry 4.0 and working actively to adopt technology for fulfilling development and governance needs. With all these advantages, we aspire to emerge as a global manufacturing hub. Friends, Thailand 4.0 focuses on transforming Thailand into a value-based economy built on science, technology, innovation, and creativity. It is also compatible with and complementary to India's priorities. India's initiatives such as Digital India, Skill India, Ganga Rejuvenation Project, Swachh Bharat Mission, Smart Cities, and Jal Jeevan Mission offer good opportunities for partnership. Friends, when India prospers, the world prospers. Our vision for India's development is such that it also leads to a better planet. When we are looking at giving top quality and affordable health care to 500 million Indians through Ayushman Bharat, it will naturally lead to a healthier planet. When we decide to eliminate TB in 2025, 5 long years before the global target of 2030, it will surely strengthen the global fight against TB. At the same time, we are sharing our success and best practices with the world too. Our South Asia satellite is helping so many people in our region, especially students and fishermen. Friends, in the spirit of our Act East policy, we are paying special attention to enhance connectivity with this region. Direct connectivity between ports on Thailand's west coast and ports on India's east coast, such as Chennai, Vizagapatnam, and Kolkata, will enhance our economic partnership. We must take advantage of all these favorable factors. We must take advantage of our geopolitical proximity like our forefathers did. Friends, given that our economies are capable and complement each other, given the commonality in our cultures, given the natural goodwill for each other, I have no doubt that we can enhance our business partnership for a win-win situation. I would like to end by saying, for investment and easy business, come to India. To innovate and starting up, come to India. To experience some of the best tourist sites and warm hospitality of people, come to India. India awaits you with open arms. Dhanyavaad. Khob khun khwab. Thank you. Thank you very much.